Okay, this is from Chapter 3, Respiratory. It's first versus second-generation antihistamines. And it seems like a simple concept, but you can actually get a lot out of it if you create the questions right, and I'll show you what I mean. So the first thing we do is we say first-generation versus second-generation, you know, what's the difference? And usually the second-generation has some kind of improvement, and third-generation, fourth-generation, and so on. So the first-generation is diphenhydramine or Benadryl, and that caused drowsiness, so that was a bad thing. And the second generation improved that by making it so it's not drowsy. So you have loratadine, which is Claritin, cetirizine, which is Zyrtec, fexofenadine, which is Allegra, and I can give more examples of first versus second generation, but these are the most common. And to learn this, or to learn any fact, you really want to do practice questions. And people get hung up on doing, you know, 100 questions, 200 questions, 300 questions, but you don't need to do that many questions. What you really want to do is have questions that help you learn from each of the answers, and that's why people look at the rationales and are so excited about the rationale. So let me show you what I mean. We're going to go through 5 practice questions, and the issue with listening to practice questions in audio is that your working memory can't process all of the 4 answers if they're not in some order or they're not related. And what I find is that, you know, you'll hear something on an audiobook or something like that about, oh, here's 1,000 questions that you can, you know, learn from. But if your working memory can't put the whole thing in your brain at once, then that's not going to be really helpful. So what we want to do is we want to create practice questions that are related, and we just change a little bit. And by changing just a little bit and having the same answers each time, it actually works out a little bit better, a little bit easier to remember. So here's a practice question. I just made it up. A truck driver asks which antihistamine he can take to stop his runny nose and sneezing today. You tell him to take A, and I'm going to actually not even mess with drug names yet, and just put the drug classes. So a very good NCLEX or NAPLEX or USMLE practice question would have every single one of the non-incorrect answers teach you something or be part of and an important part of the question. So the first answer would be a first-generation antihistamine. So I put this in green if you're watching, and if you're just listening, I'll try to go over it again and you'll see. So the first generation antihistamine makes you drowsy. So it's a person's a truck driver, and he asked for something for today. So no, we wouldn't want to use a first generation antihistamine. Second generation antihistamine, it's non-sedating. Yes, that's what we want to use. It meets all of our criteria. The truck driver needs to be alert, so it can't be sedating. It's an antihistamine. We need to stop his runny nose and sneezing, and that's the symptoms that you might have, and then it's for today. Okay. A decongestant. This is something patients often confuse, is antihistamine versus decongestant, and no, a decongestant is for nasal congestion. He has runny nose and sneezing. This wouldn't help. And then a nasal steroid, this would help, but it's neither an antihistamine, nor will it help runny nose and sneezing today. It's used for prophylaxis. It's not an acute medication. That's what makes the second one right. And what makes pharmacology so hard is that there are so many different first generation, second generation antihistamines, decongestants, and nasal steroids. But what we can do is we can create a second practice question, and we're only going to change a little bit each time. So a truck driver asks which antihistamine he can take for his runny nose and sneezing during the day, and you tell him to take. And instead of the drug classes, all I've done is replaced it with some of the most common medications. And that's really what you're going to see. As much as you think the board is trying to trick you, they're really trying to use some of the more common medications that you would more likely see. So diphenhydramine, which is Benadryl. And that would make the person drowsy, so no, that's not right. We've just switched the second generation antihistamine loratadine for something non-sedating, so yeah, that's the right answer still. And we remember that the stem, adenine, is a second-generation antihistamine. Pseudoephedrine, again, this is the decongestant, so it doesn't help with the symptoms. So no, that's not correct. And then fluticasone. The sone isn't a stem, but you'll often see it with steroids. And this is, again, a prophylactic, not an acute medication. So all we've done is change from drug classes to the drugs themselves. We haven't even changed the question. Okay? But what we want to do, because our working memory really couldn't take this much information in, is continue to repeat parts of it, but not and make a small change, and we'll make the small change in the question. So the answers are going to be the same. It's going to be A, diphenhydramine, first-generation antihistamine, B, loratadine, a second-generation antihistamine, C, pseudoephedrine, a decongestant, and D, fluticasone, a glucocorticoid or a nasal steroid. Okay, so let's see how this works. Practice question 3. A truck driver asks which antihistamine he can take for sleep at night. You tell him to take, and now, although all the answers are the same, the correct answer changes. So A, diphenhydramine, this makes you drowsy. Oh, that's good. And this is the active ingredient in Tylenol PM. The PM stands for nighttime, or post-meridian, but it really stands for at night. And so diphenhydramine would be now the correct answer, and loratadine would be incorrect because it is non-sedating. It doesn't help with sleep. Pseudoephedrine, this not only doesn't help with the symptoms, but it would actually keep them up at night, so that would be the opposite. And then fluticasone, this is a prophylactic steroid and really wouldn't help someone who's trying to get to sleep at night. So what we're really trying to do is continue with the same question or continue with the same answers so that we can learn, okay, well, the first thing we do is we learn why something is right. And then we want to learn how to make the other three right so that we really learn well how it's wrong. Okay. So again, the truck driver asks for which antihistamine you can take for sleep at night, and you tell him to take diphenhydramine because it makes him drowsy. Okay. How can we make pseudoephedrine right? Well, what we have to do is we just say, truck driver asks which medicine he can take for, and what's pseudoephedrine for? Nasal congestion. So, truck driver asks which medicine you can take for nasal congestion. You tell him to take pseudoephedrine. Now, we have to be careful here because we haven't considered some other things. Again, this is just the practice questions I've made up. But with diphenhydramine, there might be a little bit of hangover effect. And that might be a consideration if we're getting into the details. Pseudoephedrine, this might be an issue because a truck driver may not be allowed to take something like pseudoephedrine, which is a stimulant. This is what people use to make methamphetamine. So we're working within the question, and we're just looking for a nasal something for nasal congestion, but know that there might be some idiosyncrasies that go outside of the question. Okay? And then what we want to do is continue with the same question answers, diphenhydramine, loratadine, pseudoephedrine, fluticasone, and say, well, what would we have to do to the question to make fluticasone right? So practice question 5, a truck driver asks which medicine he can take for runny nose and sneezing 2 weeks before allergy season starts. You tell him to take, and now it would be fluticasone. So fluticasone is an intranasal steroid. You can use it for prophylaxis. And yes, this makes it right. So again, trying to get away from I have to do X number of questions and say, let me spend a little bit more time with each question so that I can really understand why the first answer was right. And then by making the other ones right, by changing the questions, it really helps put this into your memory.